Goedemorgen, graad 10's. Good morning, grade 10's. Thank you for attending. I'm just going to give 2 to 3 minutes for the rest of the attendees to join us. Please use this time to familiarize yourself with the dashboard or the control panel. Then I'll see you shortly. Good morning, everyone. You are at the Afrikaans Eat webinar this morning. I just want to allow another minute for everyone to attend and then we'll get started. Please familiarize yourself with the control panel on the right-hand side of your screen. You will see that there's a part where you can ask questions. This you can use during the webinar, and there's also a little hand that you can put up during the webinar. I'll ask you to just put your hand up. Just make sure that you know where all of that is. Then I'll see you shortly. Good morning, Graad 10s. Goedemorgen, Graad 10s. And welcome to the Afrikaans Eat webinar for Grade 10. My name is Carla Lamprecht, and I am the education specialist for Afrikaans. And today we have an organizer with us. You won't be able to see her. Her name is Serena Jordan. She is here just to make sure that everything is working well, that you can hear me. And should we lose signal or something drops, she'll pop up on the screen and explain to you what will happen then. We are hoping that everything will run smoothly this morning. Okay, before we start, I just want to go through some basics with you. If you are struggling to hear me, please make sure that your audio is on and that your speaker volume is turned up. It's very important. That would be your laptop or iPad or whatever you are using, make sure that the volume is turned up on your device. Okay, when you join this webinar, you will automatically be muted when you're joining the session. That is so that we don't hear everyone's background noises. Should you have any questions, you can ask your questions in the question box. You would have seen that in your control panel on the right of your screen, right hand side of your screen. I'm not going to answer any questions during the webinar. I think it will waste a lot of time, but you are more than welcome to ask your questions. And then when we have time after the webinar, I'll make time to answer them. If we don't have time, those questions will be downloaded for me to answer afterwards. So you will get an answer, whether it's during the webinar, after the webinar, or long after the webinar. Okay. During the session, I will, from time to time, ask you to raise your hand. You will see that there's a hand icon on your control panel. And you just click that so I know that you are still with me and that you are listening. Hi. To raise your hand, I just explained to you, it's on that dashboard. I think it's just below the questions. Okay. This presentation I'm giving today will be available for you to download. You will see that there's a handout box. Also on that control panel, please remember that this handout box is only available for you to download during the session. It will expire when this session is over. We have decided to put this presentation on YouTube as well. It will be communicated to you where you can find this. I'm not sure we'll let you know, but you will receive a mail or some kind of communication about that. Okay, and please remember to send your questions. Don't think because I'm not answering immediately that you won't get an answer. Still send your questions. Okay. I think let's quickly put our hands up so we can see who is attending and who is listening to me. Put your hands up. Good. Okay, there's still a few who didn't put up their hands. Let's just give them an opportunity to find their hand. Okay. Okay. I just want to remind you again to make sure that you download the handout that we've uploaded for you on the control panel so that you are not rushed to do it afterwards. We will allow a minute or two after the webinar for you to download it if you did not have the opportunity to download it during the webinar. But if you find that you have a bit of time, please do so. Okay. Then I think we can start. If everyone is here and comfortable, we can get going. Okay, so what we're going to do is I'm going to discuss the term 2's poesie with you. That is the gedichte. Okay, for grade 10, it will be Knipmes by Lochner de Kok. The first thing I want you to know is what you look out for when you are doing a poem. Waarvoor moet jy kyk in 'n gedig? First thing is stylfigure. That is poetic devices. The next one will be beeldspraak. I see there's a spelling error. And then it is the internal and external structure. Today we're not going to do the internal and external structure. I feel it's something that you should be comfortable with. If you are not comfortable with answering questions about the internal and external structure of a poem, please go back to your study guides and make sure that you know this. These are easy marks if you understand them. Okay, the first thing we're going to discuss is stylefigure, alliterasie. Dit is die herhaling van consonante, consonants. That is the repetition of anything, any words except for A, E, I, O, I. An example of this would be, die son sak stadig oor die see. Can you hear that I'm repeating the word or the letter S? Okay, so that would be alliterasie. The next thing will be assonansie. That is the repetition, die herhaling van jou vowels, A, E, I, O, I. So nou sou die pou nie langer kou. Remember, that is also the repetition of the sound. Okay, so O and so in pou, the O sound, the letter O and U creates an O sound. Dan hyperbool, that's when you exaggerate, hyper, you make something hyper. That is like saying, ek het jou al 'n miljoen keer gevra. There's no way for you to know that you've asked someone something a million times because you haven't counted. Okay, that's exaggeration. Hyperbole. Inversie. That is when you change the natural order of a sentence. You change the word order. There are two reasons people do this. The first one would be to make sure that the sentence or the verse fits in with the rhythm or the rhyme of the whole poem, van die hele gedig. Or it could be to emphasize something, om iets te beklemtoon, by putting the word at the end that's usually not there. An example of this would be to say, vergeet my nooit. The natural order of this sentence would be, moet my nooit vergeet nie. But they have now changed it to vergeet my nooit. Okay. Dan repetitie, repetition, that is when you repeat words or verses or stanzas, and that is usually to emphasize, for beklemtoning. Dan euphemisme, that is to say something that is in a more acceptable way, om iets mooier en meer aanvaarbaar te stel. Like instead of saying that someone is a thief, om te sê iemand is a thief, you would say, sy het lang vingers, she has long fingers. Okay. Or if someone is pregnant and you don't want to say pregnant, you don't want to say the word swangerskap, you can say that she's finding herself in quite an uncomfortable position, or sy is in 'n gemaklike posisie or situation. Okay. Dan 'n retoriese vraag. 'N retoriese vraag is 'n vraag waarop jy nie 'n antwoord verwag nie. You don't expect an answer. That is like saying, wat het jy gedink gaan pa doen as jy vir hom jok? What did you think will happen if you lie to your dad? Dan beeldspraak. 'N metafoor. Dit is wanneer jy iets direk met mekaar vergelyk. Okay, die magic word hierso is. That is when you compare two stuff with each other directly. That's when you say, jy is my sonskyn, of jy is my lewe is 'n donderstorm. That is not meant literally. She isn't your sunshine, she is like your sunshine. Okay, but we are not using the word like, ons sê jy is. Wanneer jy die woord is sien, dan weet jy dit is 'n metafoor. Maar sy maatjie is vergelyking. Vergelyking se magic word is soos of nes. Dit is wanneer jy sê, jy is nes 'n sonstraal, of my lewe is soos 'n donderstorm. Those are the words that you need to look out for. Can I just quickly make sure that everyone is still listening to me? Are you with me? Just put up your hands quickly, please. I see there are quite a few hands. Okay. Okay, let's carry on. Then the next one is personificatie. You should be quite comfortable with this one. That's personification. That's when you give human characteristics to something that is not human. Om menselijke eigenschappen aan een niet-menselijke voorwerp te geven. That is when you would say, die zon glimlach voor mij. The sun cannot smile. Okay. Smiling is a human characteristic. Or if you say, die car is weer kwaad vanochtend. When you start your car in the morning and it's making a horrible noise, you would say, die car is weer kwaad vanochtend. Kwaad is an emotion for a human. Okay. Therefore, it would be personification. Okay, klanknabootsing of onomatopoeia, that is when you use sounds instead of words. Okay, dit is om woorde met klanke uit te beeld, that's saying like toot toot or zoom or brr for when it's cold. Okay, dan symboliek, that is when you use words en voorwerpe om wat iets verteenwoordig, something you are using words to represent something else. That's like talking about a white dove to represent death, or a red rose to represent love, or when you talk about sunrise, it could be that you are talking about a new beginning or a new start to something, a venture or whatever. Next one. Okay, now I'm going to read the poem Knipmes to you. And you can just listen. I'm going to try and do it very slowly. I tend to talk very fast, so I'm going to try and do it very slowly. So you can just listen to me. Listen to how I pronounce the words. If there are words that you don't understand, please don't get panicked. I'm going to explain those words to you at the end. Knipmes deur Logner de Kok. 'N taal is soos 'n knipmes, blink. Hou hom skerp, gebruik hom flink. En as jy hom die slag oopmaak, moenie aan sy skerp kant raak, want soms is hy stomp, soms heel skerp. Hang net af hoe jy met hom werk. Hou jy hom skoon en blink geslyp, sal hy jou woord en daad verryk. Maar raak hy stomp, is dit verby, sal jy die woord met moeite kry. As jy hom bære nooit uithaal, sal jou gedagtes jou bly val. Een woordmes wat sekuur kan sny, sal jou maklik deur die lewe kry. Want kan jy nie sê wat in jou kop aangaan, sal die woord tekort jou bly beskaam. I'm just going to give you a quick summary of what this is about. Okay. The first thing you need to know is a knipmes is a pocket knife. Okay. This poet is comparing a knipmes, a pocket knife, to taal, a language. Okay. He is saying that if you use language like you would a pocket knife, if you use it often and you use it effectively, it can benefit you. There is a use for it. Okay. As jy dit bære, kan jy dit nie gebruik om jou gedagtes in woorde uit te druk nie. If you put it away, then it has no use. If you put your language away and you don't use it properly, it means that you can't express your thoughts in words. Om die gedig te verstaan, moet een mens throughout deurgaans onthou dat die taal is wat hier beskryf word. You need to remember that he is explaining or describing language. Okay. And he's comparing it to a pocket knife, but the main thought here is language. Dit is moontlik dat mense knipmes vir selfverdediging gebruik. It is possible that you would use a pocket knife for self-defense. It could be that the poet is also talking about how if you use language effectively, that it can also be used to defend yourself in situations, because you are able to express your thoughts and you can say what you mean efficiently. Okay. Now, just to explain to you the words that you might have found hard to understand. The word knipmes is a pocket knife. Okay. They say hou hom skerp, gebruik hom flink. When you use something flink, it means that you are using it thoroughly and with a zeal. Dan moenie aan sy skerp kant raak. Skerp kant of a knife would be the cutting edge of the knife or the sharp edge of the knife. Want soms is hy stomp, stomp is blunt. Soms heel skerp, skerp is sharp. Hou jy hom skoon en blink geslyp? If something is geslyp, it is sharpened. So in Afrikaans you would say, I'm busy, ek slyp die messe. Means that you are sharpening the knives. Okay. Sal jy jou woord en daad verryk? Daad is a deed or an action. Om iets te verryk means you are enriching something. Sal jy die woord met moeite kry? It means that you will find the words with difficulty. As jy hom bære, not bære, bære, you will see that it has the copy on the E. It means to put something away or to store it. You would say, gaan bære jou klere, it means to put away your clothes. Sal jou gedagtes jou bly val? If something is fall or something is falling you, it means it is failing you. Meaning jou gedagtes sal jou bly val, it will fail you. Your thoughts will fail you. 'N woordmes, directly translated, is a word knife. And secure is to do something accurately. Okay. In the last one is sal die woord tekort, word so shortage. Beskaam is it will put you to shame or will disappoint you. Right. Okay, now we're going to do the discussion, die bespreking. That is the important part of this. You will see that this poem is divided into two stanzas, strophe 1, strophe 2. Okay, now let's talk, let's go through every verse together. 'N taal is soos 'n knipmes, blink. Already you should have seen the word soos. Okay. Soos meaning vergelyking. Okay. Hou hom skerp, gebruik hom flink. Hom is referring to the taal and the knipmes. It's referring to the language and the pocket knife. Now just saying that you need to use it the right way. Gebruik dit reg. As jy hom die slag oopmaak, again, this could be the pocket knife and it could be the language. So you are saying, as jy hom die slag oopmaak, if you open the pocket knife or if you open the language, it could be that when you open your mouth to speak or use your language, or it could be that you are, jy praat reguit. Okay. Moenie aan sy skerp kant raak, want soms is hy stomp, soms heel skerp. Hang net af hoe jy met hom werk. Okay, means don't touch the sharp edge, because it might be blunt or it might be sharp. It depends on how you work with it. Okay, it means that wees versigtig om aan iets te vat wat jy, wees versigtig om aan iets, oh, sorry, I made a mistake, yeah. Wees versigtig om aan iets te vat wat jy nie weet of het stomp of scherp gaan wees. Be careful when touching something when you don't know if it's going to be blunt or if it's going to be sharp. The reason he said this is that if you don't use your language effectively and in the right way, you might end up offending someone. Okay. Scherp taal, it would also be like when you say someone has a sharp tongue, it means that they are quite ruthless with what they say, they are rude or offensive. So it's important for you to know to use language correctly. And like it would be to use a pocket knife correctly, because if you open it and you touch the sharp edge, you will cut your finger. Okay. Hou jy hom skoon en blink geslyp, sal hy jou woord en daad verryk. This means that if you keep your language clean, sober, without mistakes, and you keep it blink geslyp, and you keep it sharpened, you keep up to date with your language, It can enrich your word and your deeds. Maar raak hy stomp, is dit verby, sal jy die woord met moeite kry. If you get lazy with language and you don't work on keeping up to date and making sure that you use the correct grammar and the correct words when you want to express your thoughts, you might end up having difficulty to explain yourself. You will have trouble or difficulty to find the right words to explain yourself or to express your thoughts. Elf, as jy ombare nooit uithaal, sal jou gedagtes jou bly vol. If you put away your language and you don't use it often, gedagtes sal jou bly vol. Means that you might have very good thoughts, but you won't have the words to explain or to express those thoughts and communicate those thoughts, therefore it will fail you. Your thoughts will therefore be useless, nutteloos. Okay, I'm going to discuss the whole last stanza with you. 'N woordmes wat sekuur kan sny, sal jou maklik deur die lewe kry. Want kan jy nie sê wat in jou kop aangaan, sal die woord tekort jou bly beskaam. Wanneer jou woorde jou idees effektief oordra, sal daar nie misverstande wees nie en sal dinge met jou goed gaan. That means when you can explain your thoughts effectively, it lessens the misunderstandings that might be possible to happen. But wanneer jou taal sleg is, when your language is bad, it might embarrass you. Dit sal jou in die verleentheid stel, wanneer jy nie jouself kan uitdruk nie. If someone has very great ideas, but they don't know how to explain it to you, they don't have the words to explain exactly how they feel, it might end up embarrassing them. Okay, then we are done. Okay, I hope that this made sense to you. You will find this in your book. In term two, it's the first gedicht that you do in term two. I just want to make sure that I can see everyone. This is now an opportunity for you to ask questions if I don't get to all the questions. I will answer them afterwards. Okay, let's see. So I just need to open everything here. We are very new to webinars, just so you know. I just maybe want to mention something. In literature, in poetry especially, if you can substantiate the way you see a poem, it can't be marked wrong. Okay. I have such a good example of this for the grade 11s, where it speaks about a woman that looks in the mirror, but they don't say if she's looking at someone else. It doesn't say if she's looking at herself. So if you can see it anyway, as long as you can substantiate, if you can explain why you see it like that. Okay. Will there be more webinars for next week? Yes, we have webinars every week, but it won't be for Afrikaans next week. So we did it every second week. Okay, but you will receive notes next week. And I'm going to keep the notes on literature. I'm thinking about just keeping you up to date. Should this lockdown be extended, I want you to be calm and know where you should be with your work. So I'm definitely going to just give you a type of timeline just to keep you on track. To keep you on track. Okay. Sure, a lot of questions. Yes, the work that you we did now is the first poem in term two in your MPAC book. No, I can't see that you are in your pajamas. Yes, the whole webinar that I did, this whole presentation, the PowerPoint presentation that I did, is on the handout bar that you will see on your control plan. Please make sure that you download it quickly because it's going to expire after this session. So download it very quickly. The whole presentation, not only the PowerPoint, the whole presentation will also be available for you. It will be loaded onto YouTube. I forgot the link now, but we will send it to you. We will make sure that you get that link to the YouTube video. Oh, why don't you have sound? You will remember when I did the basics with you at the start, you needed to make sure that your sound was turned up. Just remember that. Oh, what page is this in the book? What page is this? I think I will answer this for you to make sure that you know on which page it is. I will communicate it with you after this. Oh, I see a lot of you couldn't hear. A hyperbole is when you exaggerate. That's when you say, ek het jou al 'n miljoen keer gevra. En kyk wat kos hierdie brood, dis omtrent 'n miljoen rand vir hierdie brood, of dis 86,000 rand. It's not really that expensive, but it's just a way to say that you've waited a long time, or it's very expensive, or you've asked a lot of times already. You didn't actually count. Previous webinars, this is the first webinar we're doing for Afrikaans Eat, but there are webinars available for the other subjects. That's also on the YouTube channel. I will just let you know what that link is, and also where you can find the handouts. I'm not sure. Yes, this is for Impact Afrikaans Second Language. If you are using, if you're not using Impact, you might not do this bone. But that's, don't worry about it, because this will still teach you how to answer a poem and how to look at a poem from start to finish. Okay. Taught where to look out for personification and vergelykings and hyperbole. Yeah, you need to study all the literature. For your June exam, you will need to do all the literature, everything that you've done for term one and for term two. And then for November exam, you need to do all the literature from term one up to term four. But next week, I'm going to give you notes to say exactly what you need to know when. And the reading books, I will give you notes on that. Gedig is a poem. Okay, the notes. We don't have notes on this, but I have the whole PowerPoint for you if that is what you are referring to. Please make sure that you download it at the handout box in your control panel on the right-hand side of your screen. It is just, I think mine might look a bit different than yours. You download it at handouts. No, I won't be giving you all your webinar classes like math. I will definitely not be giving you math. I'm just doing the Afrikaans EAT, so the eerste addisionele taal Afrikaans. there is someone else that's doing the Afrikaans home language. If you already did all the poems for term one, that's perfect. You have to already have done them. You will just need to study them again for your exam. We don't know when you're writing exam. I don't think there's been a decision made in regards to are we going to write it in the holiday or if it's going to fall away. I have no idea what's happening with the November exam, June exam. But if you are going to write a June exam, please make sure that you know your term one's poems. Okay. I'm assuming that you've done them already. That's why I'm focusing on term two, because this lockdown is now going into term two. So that's my focus with you. Oh, someone asked how many kids are attending the webinar. Fun fact, 170. The reason why I am iemand vra so hoekom word die Afrikaans meer in Engels aangebied, because I've learned through the years that it's very difficult for Afrikaans eat. For some people it's their third language. So if I don't understand, if I don't explain in Afrikaans and English, it is very hard for people to understand. Okay. But if you are struggling with English and would rather want me to do it just in Afrikaans, let me know, then we have to do something. Oh, thank you. Someone just let me know that the poem is on page 148. In your study guide. Which hand is raised, red or green? I think when you raise your hand, there might be a red stripe through it, and that is to say that if you click the red, it will go down. Woordeskat is vocabulary. The webinar classes continue after the lockdown? I'm not sure. I'm not sure if that will be possible because we will be back at the office then. It depends on what the plans is for us there. There is an Afrikaans Huistaal webinar. Okay, the notes is, it's very important. It's very important. I hope that you have done this already and that I'm a bit behind with the questions. It's important that you download the handouts, the presentation. The easiest way to learn or study poetry for the exam, it's very important that you know your terminology. If you know your beeldspraak and you know your stylefigure and you know the innerlijke and uiterlijke structure, sorry, for your poetry, you'll be able to answer any poem if you understand it. And just try and think of a deeper meaning, because it's very seldom it is straightforward in your face the way it's meant. There are notes for other subjects, yes. If lockdown is extended, how will the exam situation work? And we will definitely let you know when we have clarity on that. We are still very unsure, but the president will most likely explain to us if it will be extended this week. Some things you can do before you read a poem that can help you understand better is look at the title of the poem. The title of the poem should already give you some kind of idea what it will be about. So if it says knipmes, you already know that it will have something to do about a pocket knife. Okay, then if you, the language part will catch on somewhere in the first stanza or in the first two verses. But look at the title and try to already guess what it could be about, and that should help you. No, I can't see you. Yeah, it's so difficult because I see how someone said that they are struggling to understand the English. Hulle sukkel om die Engels te verstaan en iemand anders is net weer baie dankbaar. Laat ek dit in Engels ook doen. Ek sal bietjie gaan sit en dink hoe ons julle almal kan akkommodeer. Ek dink as ek alles moet vertaal Afrikaans en Engels kan ons dalk 'n rukkie besig wees, maar dit is nie onmoontlik nie. It's not impossible to do it in both languages. It might just take a bit longer. Oh, guys, I'm hoping that I'm not skipping some questions yet. You may be excused to have breakfast. The next Afrikaans Eat lesson will be not next week, the week after that. In English, you call it a simile. In Afrikaans, it's called a vergelijking. Drie nege. If you don't have any questions left, you may leave the webinar. Okay, let me just quickly go before all of you leave. Let me just go through. Okay, here's just some information for you. Okay, if you are not registered with MPAC and you would like to register with MPAC, please contact us at info@mpac.co.za. Okay, I think I might be through most questions. I'm just trying to, I see a lot of you ask the same questions, so I'm trying to filter them so I don't repeat myself. Does Google Translate help? It does. In a crisis situation, it will help you, but remember Google Translate doesn't take context into consideration. Okay, just remember that. If you want to look for a specific word, just make sure that the translated word on Google Translate is still in context of the sentence that it has to be used in. Yeah, if you have no questions and you are comfortable and you know everything you need to know, because I know that you probably have a lot of other work to do, you are welcome to leave. And thank you for attending. Why do the webinar start so early? Because I'm doing the webinar with you, and after this I'm doing 11, and then I'm doing grade 12, and then the afternoon session is another subject. So for us to fit in everything and make sure everyone gets the help that they need, we have to start this early. Well, think of it, if you were going to school, you would have been up early anyway. Let's see it like that. Yeah, for Afrikaans Eat Grade 10, this is all for today. Sorry, I just want to look at them. Oh, sorry, I'm pressing the wrong button here. Oh, guys, sorry, I'm trying to. We still have a few minutes. I'm saying again, if you feel comfortable, just remember if I skipped your question, I will answer it afterwards. Okay? Because there's quite a lot. There's a lot of questions, and I have to filter because it will take me more than 15 minutes to do that. So I'm trying to look forwards. Please remember to provide YouTube link. We'll do so. Oh, your guided learning is not logging in. Please will you just contact the call center and find out what the problem is. I won't be able to help you with that, unfortunately. So there are questions about other other topics in Afrikaans. We will have a webinar on those, so don't be worried. And there is no presentation available for last term. We only started doing these webinars when we heard that we are going into a lockdown. So unfortunately there won't be any presentations for you about last term. What is daadverryk? That is when you enrich a deed. Okay. Let me just think of a practical example. But deed of daad is a deed or an action, and to enrich is to or verryk is to enrich your daad of your actie. Okay. Please don't make the exam hard. We will try. We are not mean. There will be a roster sent out to you each week about the webinars that will take place during that week. Oh, I see a lot of you ask where the PowerPoint is, and it's making me very nervous. I'm so scared that you aren't able to download it. Please just quickly send me a message if you can't download, or a question. If you still can't download the handout, or if you don't know where to find it. Sal jy dan nog 'n sessie doen in die toekoms met taal en prosa ook? Ons gaan daarna kyk vir jou om dit te doen. Ek dink die grootste bekommernis vir die studente is die letterkunde. So ons fokus maar op die letterkunde en maak seker julle verstaan dit en dis ook 'n dis 'n baie moeilike komponent van Afrikaans vir mense om self te leer. So ons gaan dit is maar ons eerste prioriteit en dan gaan ons definitief kyk as al tyd is vir die prosa en die taal ook. Reinhard Gelderhuis, ek sien jy het vir ons die YouTube link gestuur, baie dankie. Dus die volgende vak wat aangebied word. The webinar will be for the grade 11s. I don't have an English translated version of the handout. I can't have it purely in English, but I have tried to translate it on the presentation or on the PowerPoint that you will download. I have tried to translate it at places where I think you might struggle. Okay, I see that you're saying that you can't download it because your iPhone is not giving you an option to do so. Okay, I will make sure, I'm making a note of that and just make sure how we get it to you. We have to realize that most of you will do it from phones, right? Yeah, it will be sent to you afterwards. Let me just make sure how. Okay, I think that's all the questions for now. Presentation, thanks. Can you very much? Okay, I think most of the questions have been answered now. Thank you very much for joining this webinar. I appreciate it that you take your education still seriously in the pandemic that we find ourselves in. I want you to please stay motivated and isolated. Keep safe. Thank you very much for joining.